We thank God for his blessings. We thank the Lord keeping us in his care. We thank the Lord for all he has done for us. The Lord is good. His mercy endures to all generations. Matthew chapter 14 is our text today. I want to look at verses 13 and 14. Jesus said, "And whatsoever ye shall ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If ye ask anything in my name, I will do it."
Amen.
I will.
I will.
Jesus talking. Do it. We thank you, Lord, for your divine word. We thank you for your divine promise. Now, God bless us as we preach your word, as we come before this your people. Lord God, we ask you to forgive us of sin, to cleanse us from unrighteousness, and to fill us with the Holy Ghost. Oh God, let us hear what thus saith the Lord. Let us hear what heaven has for us today. And let us, oh God, walk in the path of righteousness to do your will in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I want to ask a question to the young people and the old people today. And the question is, do you know who King Jesus is? Do you know who King Jesus is? Today is the day that the Lord hath made. We ought to rejoice and be glad in it. You see, church, God made the world and everything that dwells therein. He made the moon, the sun, and the stars. He made everything that exists in the heavens and in the earth. Everything that was made by him. God the Father. Father of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. God the Father of every Christian who names the name of Jesus Christ. He is Abba. That means he is our daddy. We can go to God in prayer through Jesus Christ the Son. We know God the Creator, God the Sustainer of life, health, and strength. God the Heavenly Father who nails the number of hairs upon our head. We know him as the one who feeds the little birds in the air. But I'm just wondering today, do we really know who Jesus is? Do we know who King Jesus is? I want to ask the question today, do we know that Jesus Christ is the second person of the Trinity? The middleman of the triune Godhead that dwells together bodily? Jesus Christ is our infinite God. He is the God-man, fully God and fully man. Or as the scholars like to call him, theotropos, God and man in one. He is God come down to earth who puts on the body of a man, yet he remains sinless, suffers a cruel death, is buried, and is resurrected on the third day. And then after that, he not only is resurrected, but now he has ascended back to heaven. And he is sitting on the right-hand side of our Heavenly Father. Oh, the question is then, of whom do we say that Jesus Christ is will determine our eternal destiny? Who Jesus is will determine, it will predicate what type and of what condition our life will be as we are inhabitants in the planet called Earth. Knowing who King Jesus really is will determine whether you go to heaven to be with our Lord or whether you end up in hell, lost, suffering, and separated from God the Father. In a place where Jesus said that there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Matthew 8:12. Some preachers say, don't preach that there is no hell. Don't put my grandma and grandpa, who was meaner than the devil, in a place called hell. Because they don't deserve it. Don't put the one who did all the wrong in that place. Don't put the one who they were such a great person and such a great personality. But unless they accept Jesus as Lord and Savior, that's where they're going. Amen. And that's what Jesus said. Like or not. Yeah. So knowing who Jesus is and what power he's possessed is to accept the fact that we are children of God, that we have rights, privileges, and power to overcome the world and all the troubles therein. I heard somebody say the world is getting so much terrible. The world is getting so much crueler. But yet, when the world gets worse and worse, we as Christians, guess what? Must get better and better.
Amen.
Because we are what? The salt of the earth. If the salt has lost its savor, what good is it? But to be what? Trampled under the feet of what? Men. Isn't that what the book says? And so we as Christians must be that light to the world of darkness. Because they have no other examples but us. Someone sang a song and said, God only has your hands, your feet, your eyes, your body to use. He's not going to speak through a horse or a donkey. He could if he wanted, because he's done it in the book.
Okay.
But his normal transmission is through men and through women. Is how he speaks to the world. And so we must know who Jesus is and what power we possess. And what place we hold in the kingdom of God. Yeah. We must understand the fact that God, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit are three persons in one Godhead. Or if you would, three persons in one essence. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. These three are one. Look at verses 1 through 4 of chapter 14. And look at what Jesus says here as penned by the Apostle John. Jesus said, and note the real words of Jesus says. He says, let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. Now stay with me. In my Father's house are many what? Mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you, stay with it.
Mm-hmm.
And if I go, or because I go, and prepare a place for you, look at what he says. I will come again and receive you unto myself. Why are you going to do that, Jesus? He says that where I am, there ye may be what? Also. And whether I go, ye know. What else he says? And the way, you know. Don't talk about you don't know where Jesus is. don't try to pretend like you don't know where Jesus resides. He said you know because I told you so. And now he expected the church to tell the world that Jesus is in heaven. But that the Holy Ghost is here dwelling in our hearts. You see, the disciples were troubled in heart because he had let them know earlier that he was going away. And he had told them that it was necessary to leave them and he had to die. But on the third day, he would rise again with all power in his hand. He also let them know that he would come again to take them back to heaven with him. And this is called the rapture of the church. Paul talked about the rapture in Thessalonians and 1 Corinthians, but Jesus talked about it first. Because Jesus said that I'm going away and prepare a place for you. But he didn't leave it at that. He says, I'm going to prepare a place for you, but guess what? I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. Somebody said, on that great getting up morning, fare you well, fare you well. Going back to be with the King. We get up, take our places in the sky with the Lord.
All right.
Jesus had some work to do on these disciples because they were despondent. And they were sad in heart because they didn't want to see the Master, the one who did miracles, the one who raised folk from the dead, the one who had been there, had been their comforter, now was leaving them. And they were troubled. But Jesus had let them know at the Last Supper that he was a servant. How did he do that? Because he washed their feet. He let them know that he was a prophet because he foretold of his betrayal by Judas Iscariot. And he let them know that he was a commandment giver when he told them, a new commandment I give unto you, that ye love one another as I have loved you, that ye also love one another. I got something fresh off the press for you today. A church that doesn't love each other is not a church of God. Can I get a witness? Oh, y'all ain't heard that before. I know that's tight. I just got that just now. A church that doesn't love each other is not a, I'm gonna say it again. I got another word to put it here. A church that does not love each other is not a true church of God.
Thank you.
Am I right about it?
Yes.
Politics and all other kind of things will not help you. Where there's no love, there is no God.
Thank
you. How can I say that? Because God is what? Love. You've been reading about it and teaching in your Sunday school about it. You should know it now. God is love. Men shall know ye. Huh? By your love for one another. Oh my God, they have to be able to look at Zion and say, them some folk that love each other.
Amen.
I'll be able to come in and say, my, I can go in there because they love each other and I don't mind coming back because I know they on the right track.
Yes.
Can I get a witness?
Yes.
But if we here fighting and bickering and trying to be number one and uno numero and I'm going to let nobody out sing me and I'll preach me and I'll pray me, then you got a little problem in your church. Can I get a witness?
Yes.
Oh, I'm talking to y'all out there on YouTube, too. I'm talking to you on Facebook. I'm talking to you on Amazon. Wherever you at, Google Plus, you ain't a church. Don't have the love of Jesus. You spend more time worrying about what Donald Trump doing, but you ain't worried about what Jesus doing. Can I get a witness? Oh, somebody out there, help me, somebody. Woo! I've been watching y'all. You spend more time fighting about politics and forgot who the real king is. His name is Jesus.
Yeah,
he's coming back to take his throne after a while. So every knee going to bow and every tongue shall confess that he is Lord. Bend your knee now or bend it later. But you're going to bend it one day after a while. Get this thing together. Know that he is God. My. Jesus let the disciple know that I'm going to prepare a place for you.
Mm-hmm.
That place is in heaven.
Mm-hmm.
No use of being troubled in heart down here on earth when heaven is our ultimate resting place and our ultimate place of abode. Come good times and bad times, up and down situations, when Christians die, heaven is the prepared place for prepared people. That's verse number 3. If I go and prepare. Jesus said this place is not some place that looked like Church Street looked 50 years ago. This is a place where the streets are paved with gold. He said, I'm going. And he said, look at here, I'm going to get it prepared for you. And when you come, you ain't gonna come here talking about, I gotta sweep the streets for you, Jesus, because it's a little dirty up here. He didn't ask you to do anything. Just come on and taste and see that the Lord is good. He didn't ask you to help him prepare anything. Can I get a witness? He don't need your help. But I'm just doing it for Jesus. Jesus ain't asked you to do that for him. He said, I'll go and prepare a place for you. But I ain't just going, I'm coming back again. Folks say he's been saying that for 2,000 years, 3,000 years. Jesus is coming back. He ain't came back yet. Oh, that's all right. That's all right. But we got to keep our eyes pointed towards heaven. Because by and by, and after a while, you'll crack the sky. Every eye shall see him. We're going on to be with the Lord. But look at verses 5 through 7 real quick. Thomas says unto him, Lord, we know not whither thou goest. Mm-hmm. Question. And how can we do what? Know the way. Right. Thomas was being honest. Mm-hmm. He really had a problem with what was being said. Mm-hmm. Lord, we know not whether thou goest. We don't even know if you're going or not. You're just telling us this, Jesus. And how can we know the way? But look at the classic answer that Jesus gave. Mm-hmm. And some folk use this and don't even know what they're talking about because they don't study the Bible. They just talk. They hear themselves talk. Jesus said unto him, I am.
Wow.
I am what? The way. What else? The truth. What else? The life. Now don't miss the second part of it. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. And I was looking up there, I said, hey, when in my sermon here talking about the sheepfold? That's what Jesus was talking about. He says, I'm the doorkeeper. Thank you for that. That help right there. I'm the doorkeeper. You got to follow Jesus.
Huh?
He is a barrier of security. I'm taking off the text. Because it all goes together. We are unable to protect ourselves. Everybody else, only one doorkeeper. Mm-hmm. Only one what? Shepherd.
Amen.
All the other what? Harlots. Mm-hmm. What else are they? Thieves and robbers. What else are they? Wolves. Mm-hmm. And the folk that know Jesus know his voice, and they don't know the voice of a stranger.
Amen.
Right?
Amen.
Am I right? Am I close to teaching what you talk? Yeah, I'm pretty good at it. I like that. I'm pretty good at it. I am the good shepherd! First time I've seen this, but I can always tell you the other.
Exactly what she was saying.
True love.
True love.
Come from the Father.
Yes, sir.
Isn't that all right?
Yes, sir.
Y'all got a good teacher for you.
Perfect.
Y'all Sunday school teacher, not me. I'm talking about Sunday school teacher. I'm just jumping on the bandwagon here. I'm jumping on it. Yeah, yeah. But this is what I'm saying. That if we all stay in the book, then we can all get along. You won't be like Rodney King talking about, can we just all get along? Because we'll be along. Because we're on the same ship of Zion. Can I get a witness? We are in the same sheepfold. And Jesus is our shepherd. Am I right about it? But I like so good that my shepherd, he said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to Father but by me. Doubting Thomas. Some call him Doubting Thomas. But I call him Didymus, the honest loyalist. In other words, he was honest in his doubt. Yet he was loyal to Jesus to the end. Because remember when Jesus rose and came back in and spoke to them, Thomas said, I won't believe unless I can put my finger what, in his side and in his handprint. So he was still doubting, but he said, oh, if you can show me evidence, I'll stay on your team. Are y'all with me? He said, you show me evidence, I'll stay on the train. Other than that, I'm getting off. Bye-bye. See you later. Because I gave up all I had to be part of this fellowship. That's what he said. Fishers of men left their fishing boats to follow Jesus. He said, you were fishers. You were fishing for fish. Now I make you fishers of men. Thomas said, once he put his finger in there, he said, my Lord and what? My God. He said, I know this is God Almighty. Isn't that right? My God, my God. There are some folk today who says that there are many ways to God. I listened to somebody on TV, several folk on the internet said there are many ways. Jesus is not the only way. Come any way you want. That's what I heard. I'm just telling you what I heard. But I say to those charlatans and those snake oil salesmen and saleswomen that Jesus said, I am the way, the only way, the truth, and the life. No man come to the Father but by me. Any other way will make you what? A thief and a robber. Any other way will make you a thief and a robber. He says, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. He's the same I am that said I am, who told Moses out of the burning bush to tell the children of Israel and King Pharaoh in Egypt that I am, that I am. When he asked the question, who sent you, Moses? Who sent you to tell us to get out of Egypt? Who told you to let my people go? Tell them that I am sent me. Jesus now saying, I am. Oh, y'all don't miss that. Jesus saying, I'm the same God that told Moses, tell him I am. He's now telling all of us, I am. The way, the truth, and the life. No Jesus, you got no way of direction. No Jesus, you have no truth for freedom, because Jesus said, the truth shall set you free. No Jesus, no life, because Jesus said, I come that you might have life and have it what? More abundantly. Oh my God. Jesus also told Thomas and all of us that no man, no woman, no other way to get to the Father but by him. Got to come through the door. Somebody said you can't get under him because he's too low. Can't get over him because he's too high. Can't get around him because he's too wide. Huh? So stop trying to do it your way and do it God's way. Oh, I ought to get some witness in this place. Do it God's way, and if you do it God's way, it'll work every time. But we start cutting corners and doing everything except what Jesus says, then we start having defeats. We start losing. But when we say, I'm going to do it the way Jesus said, then victory is ours, saith the Lord. Jesus said, I am the door of the sheep. That's what y'all heard this morning. I'm saying it again. All that ever came before me are thieves and robbers. But the sheep do not hear them. He said, I am the door. Huh? If any man enter in, he shall be saved. And shall go in and out and find pasture. John 10:7-9. Look at what Philip said. Thomas said, let us know, Lord, we know not whether thou goest, and how can we know? Now Philip says, Lord, show us the Father. Now everybody got a different agenda here. Thomas says, all right, I don't know whether you're going, and how can we know? Jesus said, because I'm the way, the one, the truth, and the life. No man comes to me the Father except by me. If ye had known me, you should have known my Father also, and from henceforth ye know him and have seen who? Him. He said, when you looked at me, you saw the Father, they know who you were looking at. Because he said, I am the express image of my Father. We look just alike. Huh? Can I get a witness? Is that close? I'm just going on what the book said. Now, if I'm wrong, if the book wrong, that make me wrong. But thank God the book is right, so I can talk what I talk.
That's right.
Because I'm in the book.
That's right.
Now, if I get out the book, you say, preacher, what are you doing? Please come and let's have a talk. Let's sit down and reason about this thing. But if I come out the book, don't talk to me. Talk to God. Because I'm speaking his direct words.
All right.
Now, look at what Philip said.
Mm-hmm.
Philip said, Lord, show us who?
The Father.
And it what? Suffice. In other words, it's sufficient if you show us the Father. Look what Jesus said. Have I been so long time with you? And yet has thou not known me who? Philip? He said, Philip, I'm talking to you. Come here, Philip. You talk too much, Philip. Come here, Philip. Talk about show up to Father, and that's good enough. He said, have I been with you so long, and you have not known me, Philip? He says, he that has seen me has seen what?
The Father.
And now Jesus asked Philip a question. And how sayest thou then, show us the Father? Show us the Father. You've been looking at the Son, and you're going to talk about show the Father, and the Father is in the Son in the Father. You're talking about show us the Father? Some folk always got excuses in the church. I tell you what. This ain't right and that ain't right. Oh, if you would have just did it the way I thought you should have did it. Oh, if you should have just had it on the other day instead of this day. Oh, Lord told me to tell you. He did? All right. Why did he tell me first? When he told Moses, I do nothing except I do it by my prophet. That's what the book said. Huh? He said, if I'm going to show you, I'm already showing the pastor first. Oh, I know this tough preaching. Y'all are used to this. I got to start telling y'all what the book says. He said, if I was going to show you something, that means the pastor's already seen it. And when you go there, you have to say, come on, God bless you. Because I already knew you was coming. But if you come in some half-baked jive talking about God sent you, I'm going to send you right back to God. And I want you to ask God, why didn't you talk to the pastor first? Can I get a witness? Oh, y'all said Freeman getting down and dirty today. I gotta take this call off. I'm tired of that. Oh my God. But listen to me. Listen to me. Stop praying with God. Folks talking about Jesus, act like Jesus is some kind of chump. Huh? He ain't your baby boy next door. He's the king of the universe. You acting like he's some kind of homeboy. Jay-Z or Kanye West. You don't give him no respect like that. You give him respect as King of Kings.
Yes, sir.
Because he's God. Great God Almighty. Look at what Jesus. I like Jesus here right here. Look at verse 10. I like Jesus. Jesus still dealing with Philip. He said, believest thou not that I am in the Father? Look at what else. And the Father where? In me. The word that I speak unto you, I speak not of myself.
Mm-hmm.
Look at what he says. But the Father that do what? That dwelleth in me.
Mm-hmm.
He doeth the works.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus said, when I raised them folk up from the dead, it wasn't me. It was God in me.
All
right. Oh, y'all ain't heard nothing today. He said, when I made that man that was blind to see, it wasn't me. It was the God in me. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Woo! Good God Almighty. I'm going to stay with this a little bit. Look at this. Look at 11. Believe me that I am, where am I at? In the Father. Where else? And the Father in me. Now stay with it. Or else, do what? Do what? Believe me for the very work's sake. So if you don't believe that I'm in the Father, if you don't believe that the Father is in me, then believe me because of what I've done through the works that were done. Because he did things that were never done by any man before. No other prophets could do what Jesus Christ did. He says, look at what I've done. My works are a testimony to my divinity. Did you miss that? My works are a testimony to my Godhood. My works are a testimony that couldn't nobody else do it except God. Huh? Oh, y'all know where I'm going with this. If y'all ain't picked up now, something wrong with you. You don't know where I'm going with this. There's nothing impossible with God. Huh? Somebody look at Matthew 21, 21 real quick. Matthew 21, 21. Matthew 21, 21. Look at what it says on this one. Somebody read that for me. I don't want you to say I made it up. Somebody read it if you feel like reading. Just read Matthew 21, 21. Read it, sister.
So Jesus answered and said to them,
Assuredly,
I say to you, if you have faith and do not doubt, you will not only do what was done to the fig tree, but also if you say to this mountain, be moved and be cast into the sea, it will be done.
Keep going 22 too.
And whatever things you ask in prayer, believing, you will receive.
And whatever things do what?
And whatever things you ask in prayer, believing, you will receive.
And all things whatsoever you shall ask in prayer, believing.
All right.
This is Jesus talking. You shall receive. If you have faith and doubt not, you shall not only do that which is done to the fig tree, because Jesus cursed the fig tree.
Yes.
He cursed the fig tree because he couldn't get no figs off of it. So he said, all right, cursed be this tree.
Mm-hmm.
But also, if you shall say to this mountain,
mm-hmm.
be thou removed and be cast into the sea. What did he say? It shall be done. Look at verse 12 or 14. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, shall he do what? Also, now don't miss the second part. What else? And greater works than these shall he do. Why? Because I go to my Father. He said, I'm going back to my Father. You think I've done some works, you're going to have authority to do some even greater works. By faith. In prayer. Believing. Not doubting. I'm just giving you what the book says today. Ain't nothing else I can give you. He said, if you believe, you shall receive. Now stay with it. Look at verse 13 and 14. I'm done with it. And whatsoever you shall ask, what did it say? In my name. John 14, 13. And whatsoever you shall ask in my name, what else he says? That will I do, that the Father what? May be glorify, where at? In the Son. 14. If ye shall do what? Ask anything in my name. He says, I will what? I will do it. I don't know what else to tell you. Because Jesus made it clear. He said, ask and you shall receive. Seek and you shall find. Knock and the door will be open. I don't know how much more clear I can get. You want God to bless you, you got to ask him. Start to ask him. Whole lot of time we talking about, oh, God can do this and that. You ain't never asked him a thing. You spend more time asking your neighbor and talking about what you think God can do, but you forgot to pray and ask God to perform the promises that you said you were going to do. Can I get a witness? Y'all, somebody had to hear me today. I want to take the time I spent gossiping and talking about Sally Jane, about the hat she had on in church, and talking about Brother Jim, the suit he looked so, oh, he looked so good. I want to spend more time talking to God and asking him to take care of my problems. I want to spend some of that time and that energy I spent watching TV and watching scandals to go in prayer and say, Lord, we need a church. Y'all know I'm getting there sooner or later. You should know I was going that way. Lord, we need a church. Lord, we need a headquarters. We thank the hotel for all they've done, but time is over. Time for us to leave, because you won't even vacuum the floor. Can I get a witness? Time to leave. Oh, y'all don't want to hear this, but I got to tell you that like this. Because you act just like you don't, you have, our welcome is over. You act like the carpet has been pulled from under us. Time for us to make haste and move on. But in order for us to move on, somebody going to have to start asking. Can I get a witness? Somebody going to start going in prayer and saying, God, we need you now. Like never before. And if you say it, ask and you shall receive, we just ask it. We just believe it. By faith. That you can do it. There are some folk who got children who won't act right. Just ask God to take care of those children.
Amen.
And God will do it.
Yes,
you got a husband and wife that won't act right. Ask God to take care of the situation.
Amen.
But remember, when you ask God, you got to do it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
He said, ask in my name, that will I do, because he said that the Father may be glorified in the Son. Huh?
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
He said, basically, don't even give the glory to me. I want the glory to go to my Heavenly Father.
Amen.
Jesus made it clear.
Amen.
If you shall ask anything in my name, he says, I will do it. Isn't that what he said? Is that what the book says?
Amen.
I mean, if I'm lying, I sit down, but that's what the book says.
Amen.
Why would Jesus tell the disciples, if you ask anything in my name, I will do it, and then tell the church, I was just joking, y'all. That was just for them. that was just a joke, man. Don't take me serious. I was just using that to get them off my back. That ain't how God operates. Because guess what? God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Same God. Huh? Same God that took the dust of the earth, shaped it and formed it into man, and breathed the breath of life into the nostril of Adam. That's the same God I serve. Huh? The same God that was in the fire when they threw the three boys in. Man, I told you last week they threw the three boys in there. And he came up to the furnace and said, didn't we put three in there? Well, I see another. Looks like the Son of God. Isn't that what the book said? Where'd he come from? Jesus will walk with you in the fiery furnace. If you just learn how to call on the name of the Lord. Y'all ain't gonna help me today. Jesus will walk with you when it seems like everything is going against you. That's when you call on God. He says, I do it. So my Father can be glorified. Ask anything in my name, I will do it. He said, I love you so much that I go to the cross. He said, I love you so much that I'll die on your behalf. Jesus didn't die just to be dying, but he died because we were in sin. Because Adam had transgressed in the garden. Because sin was moved on to what they say in a perpetual manner. That has been passed on from generation to generation. Said men were born in sin and shaped by iniquity. But here comes Jesus. Goes to the cross. Sheds his blood. Says, Father, forgive them. For they know not what they do. Into my hands, thy hands I commend my spirit. It is finished. Gave up the ghost. Went in the grave. But early third day morning, got up. With all power in his hand. Because he got up, we've got a right to the tree of life. Do you know who King Jesus is? He is my King. Woke me up early this morning. Started me on my way. Somebody says he's a rock in a weary land. Shelter in a time of storm. I can go to God in prayer. And he will hear my cry. Stop crying like a little baby. And start calling on the Lord. And say, Father, I stretch my hands to thee. No other help I know. That thou withdraw thyself from me. Whither shall I go? Ain't no way else to go but to God in prayer. When you go to God in prayer, he'll hear your cry. Just take some time every once in a while. And say, Father, I need your help. Stop just a little while and say, in Jesus' name, I'm calling on you right now. God, you said you do it, and we believe it. How many believe God can do what he want to do? When he want to do it? How he wants to do it? Because he's God, and all power belongs to him. Turn it over to the master. Do you know who King Jesus is? If you don't know, I hope you know a little better today. that he is.
He is.
King of kings.
King of kings.
Lord of lords.
Lord.
Worthy
to
be praised.
Praise.
When you want to sit down and say, I'm going to look pretty today. I want to be sophisticated today. I don't want to mess my hairdo up today. That is the time you ought to be praising and giving God some praise. Sometimes you ought to just shake your head so much the weed fall right out your head and keep on shaking. Pray God Almighty, get down to the roots and the white meat and all that kind of stuff. And let the Lord know I thank you. Woo! Because he brought me a mighty long way. Had not been for God on our side, where would we be? We'd be lost. Like a ship without a sail.
Yes,
but thank you, Lord. Because he's at the ship.
Yes, sir.
He's not asleep in the bottom. He said, peace,
peace.
Be still.
Be still.
And he's still saying,
yes,
peace be still.
Yes,
though the ship may rock,
all
right, the waves may come against the boat. Might seem like the church is going downstream and we don't have a paddle.
All right.
And that's when we look around and see Jesus,
Jesus
has picked the boat up.
Yes,
and he's carrying the boat. When you thought God forgot all about you and everybody turned their back on you, that's when the Lord said, I got this.
I got
this. Huh?
All right.
And God can do anything but fail. Isn't he all right?
Yes,
somebody give God a praise today. Isn't he all right? Praise the Lord. Give God a hand today. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Lord, we thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Thank you. All you are. All you've been.
All things.
All things. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
For everything.
Everything.
Waking us up this morning.
Yes, Lord.
Giving us life, health, and strength.
Yes, Lord.
And now, God, we thank you. We thank you.
Because
we're on our way to 1622 Liberty Street. You didn't let us tear a building down and not put another one up. We're on our way to the headquarters of Zion. Where we can go. Be able to come in anytime we want.
Yes,
gotta worry about who didn't clean the rugs. Who didn't set the chairs up right. It'll all be set up.
Because
you're going to set it up for us.
Up.
And we're going to do our part. We're going to ask.
Because
you told us to ask anything in your name. You said, I will.
I will do it.
That the Father might be glorified. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
We're thanking you in advance for the miracle. And when we walk in, nobody can say we did it. We'll tell the world God did it. And we had nothing to do. The only thing we did was ask.
Ask.
The only thing we did was put it in God's hand. And we asked in Jesus' name. And you did the rest.
Yes,
thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
For everything.
Everything.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Come on, give God a praise. Amen. Praise the Lord. The doors of the church are now open.